Good evening, honored guests. As soon as we get the other individuals in, I'm going to ask if you would please. Let's give our graduates, soon to be graduates, a round of applause. Would please stand for the singing of the national anthem by our very own paraprofessional Yvonne Wright.
So proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. Oh, the we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, those bombers steam in air, gave proof through the night that flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land
Good evening. On behalf of the administration and staff at Glennville High School, it is my honor to welcome family members, Dr. Ellington, our guest speaker, members of the Cleveland Board of Education, Dr. Trent Mosley, Chief of Engagement, Kevin Conwell, our councilman, and his wife, Mrs. Conwell, GHS alumni, and the community to our graduation ceremony for the class of 2021. As challenging as this year has been, our class of 2021 took the adversity of hybrid and remote learning and defied the odds. To this end, we say thank you with grateful hearts for every ounce of support, encouragement, tears, and prayers that aided in their progress. Again, welcome, as we celebrate this momentous occasion.
Greetings. I guess somebody has to do the honors. And before I get started, guys, I want to say to you that tonight is a night that we've all been waiting for. And any graduation, whether Cleveland or any suburb, is a distinguished event. And that said, I am asking you all, our parents, our family, our friends, to let's treat this event as such. We really, 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 we worked hard to get a lot of these babies to this place. And we really want to make sure that we have the opportunity to celebrate them together. There will be times when we're going to ask you to really raise this roof for these babies. But I just want to make sure that we give honor to all the work that they've done, all the work that those teachers done, and that we can have a distinguished event. To that end, greetings, parents, guardian, family, friends, district leadership, staff, students, and our distinguished guests. It is with great privilege that I bring you greetings and a few opening remarks as we honor this class of graduates 2021. Families, being a parent before principal or any other given title, in fact, I too will be walking in your shoes on tomorrow as I have a graduate. I know just how important this day is and how long you all waited, because again, that's my reality. And like yourselves, as I look around, I know it saddens you as it has me that we had to reduce the in-person number of tickets. However, with all things considered, you, your sons, daughters, and all stakeholders, safety is and should be our number one concern. To that end, we are doing what we must to ensure safety measures are carried out. Families and future alum, although unfortunate and a stamp in history never to be forgotten, the effects of this global pandemic has shown a rallying of support for your class, particularly from our district level leadership, who, if you don't know, assumed all the costs for our students' prom, as well as costs associated with this graduation day. The district leadership wanted to ensure no additional stress on our parents. Wow. As a result, again, prom was handled, the entire bill, with all the bells and whistles. This graduation facility, security, caps and gowns, tickets, live streaming capabilities, diploma covers, t-shirts, yearbooks, and a lot of behind-the-scenes costs to make sure that these monumental events went seamless for our families. And so I would say a true measure of love and compassion for you all. Families and scholars, can we, in your loudest voice at the count of three, give thanks as if CEO Eric Gordon was here right now as to how much we appreciate what he did in the district level leadership to make sure, again, you had no worries. All you had to do was show up. So on one, two, three, and let me hear you say thank you. I don't know if you heard me. Maybe I should have put it this way, because I told you I have a daughter graduating tomorrow, and my daughter, it came with a lot of expenses. I'm still trying to figure out how I'm going to catch up. So on three, can we raise that roof and say thank you for all that has been done for all of us to take the stresses away? So one, two, three. In that same manner, if we can again, on three, raise the roof for our congratulating our 2021 graduates, you, parents and guardians, our teachers, because without this triad, this day would not be a reality. One, two, three! Yes, yes, yes! Thank you all. some of the families we talked to as early as today, we appreciate you. We love you and we honor you and we thank you for allowing us to be responsible for your young people, person. Tonight, we are going to honor them with their diplomas. And so again, we ask for your cooperation as we have our distinguished graduation ceremony. And at this time, I'm going to ask to the podium to bring you greetings from our Board of Education, Dr. Trent Mosley.
Deserve success. Special congratulations extended also to your parents, guardians, families, and friends. They share in your achievement. And likewise, I congratulate the faculty and staff who gave you knowledge and support, walking beside you on the road to this great moment. It is a proud day for them as well. Please give them a round of applause. Graduates, in taking on this rigorous demand of high school and in succeeding, you have accomplished something difficult but worthwhile that will stand you in good stead throughout your lives. So as you leave us for wonderful careers and lives, I hope that you continue to develop the character that will allow you to act with great honor and discipline in any endeavor you pursue. Remember, lead today and lead even greater with commitment, passion, courage tomorrow. Like you, who have stood on the shoulders of so many, others will now look to you as an example and will now stand on your shoulders. Your legacy begins now, and it is what you're going to do forward that brings about the change that we need. Again, congrats, and we look forward to looking up to the heights to see how far you ascend. Keep going. Congratulations.
High School, with the merger of Martin Luther King High School and Glennville High School. Yeah, give it up for that. That was a great merger. Glennville now has three career tech programs: criminal justice, dental assisting, and nursing assisting. These pathways lead to a tremendous amount of career opportunities for students once they graduate, as well as certifications that they obtain before they graduate. I will now introduce all of the students within the career tech programs and certifications that they earn. Please hold your applause to all of the student names have been read and certifications stated. Students, please stand as your name is read and remain standing until your certification has been read. Criminal Justice Pathway, Jonathan Evans. Briagene Gibson, hold your applause. Ashanti Parker. Devin Smith. These students in the criminal justice pathway have received emergency telecommunicator certification, OSHA general industry certification, first aid certification, and CPR certification. Let's give it up for them. Please have a seat. Next, dental assisting, Anori Caldwell, Amari Carson, Naya Dunlap, Tyasia Townsend, Shania Wright. These students received dental radiographer certification, OSHA certification, and CPR certification. Congratulations. And lastly, our nursing assistant pathway, Ms. McKenna Atkinson, Makisha Atkinson, Denia Foster, Kanaya Howard, Latana Reeves. Hold your applause. Hold on. I know. It's great. Hold on. Latana Reeves, Tamira Stanky, Taylor Thompson, and Akira Waller. These students. Hold on. Hold on. It gets better. It gets better. Hold on. These students receive certification as STNA, State Testing Nursing Assistants, as well as CPR. Congratulations to all of you. And next, we will have a parent appreciation for Councilman Kevin Conwell.
So as your name is called, if you would please come forward and receive your plaque and then remain standing so that we can get a photo with all of you, please. Starting with number 10, with a grade point average of 3.51, sensational senior, Anari Simone Caldwell. Number 9, with a grade point average of 3.60, sensational senior, Aaliyah A. Crowell. Number 8, grade point average 3.62, sensational senior, Beyonce T. Willard. Number 7, grade point average 3.67, Janaea L. Thomas. Number 6, grade point average 3.67, Deja S. Miller. Number 5, grade point average 3.69, sensational senior, McKenna S. Atchison. Number 4, grade point average 3.82, sensational senior, Terrell A. Colbert Jr. Number 3, grade point average 3.85, Latona C. Reeves. Number 2 and salutatorian, grade point average 3.92, Danasia D. Fortson. And number 1, valedictorian, grade point average 4.08, Tanaya Parker. And please give them another round of applause, our top 10 class of 2021. Thank you. Councilman Conwell and Councilwoman Conwell, if you would come forward.
Here to celebrate these young people today. Thank you. I'm Councilwoman Conwell from the county, glad to represent this district. I don't know if it's a surprise, so I'm gonna say this is for one of the Mothers Out There and Families Together Year Award. She is the parent of twin daughters, McKenna and Makisha Atkinson. We would like to thank you. Come on, come on. Come on down, Darlene Graham. We would like to thank you for going over and beyond for your children and the administration. God bless you, Darlene Graham.
Thank you.
You gotta take a picture and take it out of the.
I didn't want to smush it or mess it up, so. I left that for her.
She wanted it for the picture.
I wanted her fingerprints. One more time for the Mother of the Year.
Thank you for being there for our children. This one, you know, Father's Day is coming up, and this is the Fathers and Families Together of the Year Award. It's for John Wallard. Is John here? Willard. Is John Willard here? She said he better be here. But let me say this. John is an engaged father. And here's the thing about our children. We live through our children. And is that John coming out right now? It's important. John, you know, as they say in the fatherhood movement, our children don't want to know about you. They want to know you, John. They want to know that you care about them. They want to know what verses in the Bible that you study. They want to know what color you like. They want to know that you really care for them. And you are the man. Congratulations.
Okay,
all right. John, he is the parent of a graduating senior, Vianse Willard.
Yes.
Pronouncing it right.
Yes.
The class of 2021. Where your baby at?
She didn't make it.
She didn't make it?
No.
Okay. Father-child bonding. We would like to thank you for going beyond and promoting father-child bonding. This award has the support of Councilmember Kevin Conwell, who is a mighty, mighty tall blooder. Mighty, 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 mighty tall blooder.
Right.
County Councilwoman Yvonne Conwell and Mayor Frank Jackson. So here you are, brother.
Okay, well, thank you. Okay.
Oh, wait a minute, hold on.
excellent example of what it means to be an exceptional student. Not only is she intelligent, funny, and an all-around joy to be around, but she is caring and helpful to students and staff alike. Denisha takes full responsibility for her education and lends her assistance in helping others, her peers, reach their educational goals. When she is not hitting the books, she is preparing for her fictional rap career under the equally fictional persona of D-Bands. Welcome to the stage, Denisha Foster.
I came to Glennville my ninth grade year. I came to Glennville not only because my other siblings went to Glennville, but because my parents saw the family-like environment and administrator and staff at Glennville. I am grateful for the journey that I encountered here at Glennville. I remember my ninth grade year having Ms. Gully class for Algebra 1, and I ended up getting a C for the first time on my report card. I was so upset. My parents knew it was only because I was adapting to a new school, so they pushed me to do better and study more. And from that day forward, I was happy, because from then on, I stayed on high honor roll. This is why I gave all them to my parents, being in the top 10 and second in my class. I love them because they were active participants in my education, attending all school functions, whether it was a conference, open house, or other special school events. When I tell you, my mom inspires me because she's the strongest person I know, especially today when I say both of them are attending my school events. No matter what, my mom is here alone because I lost my father earlier this year. This year has not been the best year for me, due to COVID and losing motivation when my dad passed away. It was my mom, seeing her continue to live. And I decided to keep pushing through because I know my dad would be proud of me. I still applied to college and got accepted for nursing. However, I decided to go to Tri-C so I could stay home and assist my mom. I had promised her that I would continue my education after attaining my associate degree at Tri-C. High school has taught me to be open to new ideas. As a member of the track team for my ninth grade year and basketball for my 11th grade year, I also learned that sometimes it takes a team to accomplish goals. We may not always get to the finish line. Things may get in your way. Must stay focused and push forward towards your goal. I want to thank my coaches, teachers, for pushing me to do the best I could be. For the class of 2021, we had to face COVID and learn remotely. That was definitely a challenge because most of us are hands-on and not really into online learning. In high school, you face many obstacles, such as going to different schools, meeting new crowds, learning new things, but you have the opportunity to make something memorable happen out of it. With that being said, anything is possible, so keep striving to make your goals and accomplish them. The educators were supportive and helpful with the challenges for me. The class of 2021 should be thankful for each of them. I want to thank my teachers, friends, and family. Family, I love you. You motivate me to do my best, even when I see my best or I am motivated to do anything. You guys continue to motivate me. I remember my favorite Bible verse I keep in mind is Philippians 4, verse 13. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Congratulations to the class of 2021. I wish you well and a peace of mind to do your best, even that if it's your all. We all can accomplish our greatest dreams. I am Denisha Fortson, the Salutatorian of 2021.
I have the honor and the pleasure of introducing our valedictorian, Ms. Tanaya Parker. Please welcome her to the stage.
Good evening, respected guests, staff, family, friends, and fellow graduates. My name is Tanaya Parker, and I'm the valedictorian of the Glennville High School class of 2021. It is a great honor to address my classmates and everyone who has come to support us. We all worked hard to be here and finish the year as best as we could, despite COVID and the challenges it presented. Today is the day we prove that it is not a pandemic that can hold us back. Today marks a new chapter in our lives, shaping us into the people we aspire to be. I have attended Glennville from 9th to 12th grade. When I enrolled for my 9th grade year, I had recently moved back to Cleveland from Erie, Pennsylvania. Being new, not seeing any familiar faces, and starting 3 weeks late, 9th grade year was a bit tricky. I was getting into unnecessary drama, and I was not mature enough to just walk away and not let trivial things bother me. I would like to thank Ms. Bell for always giving me an opportunity to move above my mistakes and give me a slap on the wrist in most cases because she saw the potential in me. She once said, "You must have someone positive around you, someone who can see something in you that you are too blind and distracted to see for yourself." And she was right. I found that within my 4 years of attending Glennville from the staff and friends I encountered throughout my high school experience. I am sure we picture ending this chapter in our lives differently and being able to rejoice in a manner in which you are more familiar, no mask or social distancing. The coronavirus pandemic changed the way things were done this year. We were fortunate to have a prom and even a real graduation. However, we missed out on our memories, senior experiences, field trips, homecoming, and bonding with teachers and friends in the school environment. We moved smart through these times and never gave up, even when giving up felt like the only reasonable thing to do. This pandemic made us strong and taught us that in life, obstacles are thrown at us, and we must make adjustments, not give up, and find another way to accomplish the things we want to accomplish. Congratulations to everyone who has been accepted into college, signed up for a trade, decided to stand up and support our country, decided to start a business, or have yet to decide your next steps in life. Your family, the staff, and your friends at Glennville will continue to love you and support you. Have faith in you and yourself and believe that anything you picture for yourself can come true if you never give up and never stop believing in yourself. Surround yourself with people that uplift you and see the best in you and want to see you succeed. Never give up and never stop trying. With success comes failure, so you shouldn't be afraid to fail and never let them bring you down. These situations make you stronger, and you can learn from them and become a better you. I want to thank my teachers who never gave up on me and always went above and beyond to make sure I was where I needed to be. I would also like to thank my closest friends. No need to name you all, but you were always there for me and having the best intentions in our friendships. I would also like to thank my mother, my father, my friends, Derek, Chanel, Denisha, JoJo and Lala, and Deja. Even though sometimes we may not be on the best terms, they were always there for me when I needed them. They gave me good advice and have been there in the worst times of my life to help me see the bright side of every downfall. I love all y'all, you know. I am so honored to earn my place on the wall of graduates as a valedictorian of the class of 2021. There are so many to thank, but I want everyone who has played a part in my life to know how thankful and grateful I am to have them in my life. In closing, I would like to end with our class motto: "With every ending is a better beginning." With that being said, I would like to again congratulate all my peers and classmates. Congratulations to class of 2021.
My name is Shanita Horton. I am a senior and junior English teacher and a proud Glennville alum of class of 1995. Oh, y'all didn't know. When I received the opportunity to come back and teach at Glennville, it was a no-brainer. Glennville is home. It's been home. My parents have a house in Glennville. I lived in Glennville for forever. I just came back to where I started. But our speaker, on the other hand, she asked, she made a request to come back so that she could give to the school that gave so much to her. Dr. Tamika Ellington is an associate professor of design at the Kent State University's Fashion School and interim associate assistant dean for the School of the Arts. She was the first and only African-American professor of fashion. Her work has been shown internationally, including two exhibitions in Beijing, China. She publishes research in the discipline of social psychological aspects of dress for African-Americans and other minorities, such as people with disabilities. Her publications on hair have reached national and international recognition via peer-reviewed journals, as well as dress and culture encyclopedias. Dr. Ellington is also the CEO and founder of the First Generation Revolutionaries Movement. Not only is she an internationally acclaimed and awarded educator and scholar, Dr. Tamika is a motivational speaker, professional development strategist, and first generation advocate. Dr. Ellington is the author of Make Fear Your Superpower, a witty and real memoir that speaks to the inner courage that we all possess. She has also released her second book, Be the GOAT, a career readiness manual. She is dedicated to helping others face their fears so that they can have the power to challenge their way of being. Her mantra is, revolutionize your way of thinking. At this time, I would like to introduce my fellow Glennville class of 1995 alum and caring friend of more years than I want to tell you, Dr. Tamika Ellington.
I'm not sure if I'm going to use this mic. It seems like it's been a little bit muffled. Can you guys hear me okay? Okay. So about 2 years ago, I had a dream about you guys. I had a dream about being able to come back and to be able to give of some of the things that I got. And so since 2003, I've been teaching college. Not only did I find out that teaching was my calling, but I found out that inspiring people was really what I was brought here to do. I would get really cool little cards from some of my students saying how I increased their self-esteem or how I made them believe that they could do whatever they wanted to do. And that got me thinking, how can I impress upon young people that they have everything that they need to be successful? Everything that you need to be successful, you have it already. I wanted to be able to figure out a way that I could do that on a grander scale. So I took myself out of the classroom and I began speaking at larger engagements so that I can touch more people. My goal is to touch millions of young people, to give them the gift of believing in themselves. And so when I was thinking about coming back here, when I was dreaming about home, one of the first things that I thought about was my experience. No, I didn't even, did I?
Yeah.
Okay, all right. So I was thinking about my experience being at Glennville High School and what that was like, and growing up in the Glennville area. I grew up on 105th and St. Clair. I experienced a lot of the same things that you guys experienced. It's not very easy living in the inner city. Sometimes this can be dangerous. I had to carry something with me all the time. Sometimes it could be stressful because of just the day-to-day trying to survive. And so I wanted to be able to give you a piece, just a little small piece of what I've been able to attain. And so when I think about the dream that I have for you guys, I envision myself being here with you, giving you some skills that you can take with you and do whatever it is you want to do with this life. When you go out and you get some abundance, abundance basically means abundance in life, having everything that you could possibly want, not just monetarily, but also personally. Abundance in friendships, abundance in your thinking. That is the one that's really, really important, to have abundance in your thinking, because when you think that there's no limit to what you can do, then all the doors are open to you. Every door that you want is open. When you get a little bit of that abundance, it's your responsibility to come back and bring it back to those coming behind you. And so that's why I'm here today, is because the abundance that I've been able to get, it's not mine to keep. My abundance is not mine. My abundance is to share. Just like when you get your abundance, your responsibility is going to be to share that with those people coming after you. And so over the years, I've been able to acquire some skills and techniques to help me get through all the tough times, all the crap that I had to deal with. And so I call my abundance fire. Fire is an acronym for fearlessness, integrity, and revolutionary, and excellence. Fire is an acronym for fearlessness, integrity, revolutionizing your thinking, and excellence. And so when I'm talking about fearlessness, I'm not talking about a situation where you're never gonna be afraid. Every time we do something different, every time we do something new, we're gonna be afraid. But what I'm talking about is being afraid and doing it anyway. Being afraid and doing it anyway, because when you're afraid, if you don't do it, you're gonna be stagnant. Stagnant means you're staying still. You're not doing anything, okay? Something that has helped me over the years is my spiritual faith. I'm a very spiritual person. I don't consider myself a religious person. I consider myself a spiritual person. And so my spiritual faith has gotten me through many, 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 many struggles. And so when I think about when I'm fearful, when there's something that I want to accomplish and I'm really scared about accomplishing that, I go back to the Bible. I go to Isaiah 43:1. Isaiah 43:1 says, "Fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name, and you are mine." What that means is that the source, our creator, whether you call him God, Allah, Jehovah, whatever it is you call him, there's one source. The one source, we come from the one source. So the same power that the source has, we have that same power in us. That same power that the source has, that source gave that same power to us. And knowing that has become my superpower. It made me feel like I could do anything. When I know I come from the source, I can do anything. And so my journey on my fearlessness really stemmed from the fact that I was first. I was first in a lot of different things in my life. I'm the firstborn. I have two brothers, or I have a sister and a brother. There's three of us. I'm the firstborn. I'm the first person in my family to get a college degree. I'm the first person to be a doctor in my family. And so Being able to get that college degree, being able to get a PhD, allowed me to become the very first Black professor ever in the School of Fashion at Kent State University. But getting there was not easy. Getting there was not easy. I ended up having to file an affirmative action case against the fashion school because I applied 3 times for a job and they denied me all 3 times. So I had to take some of that fearlessness that I knew I had and do what I knew I had to do. And once I did that, then they gave me a job, magically. I got a job, right? So you have to stand up for yourself, and I had to be fearless and stand up for myself. But one of the things that's interesting about being fearless, and one of the things that's interesting about doing the things that you want to do, oftentimes, unfortunately, you're not going to be able to work with people that look like you. You're going to be working in these PWI spaces, these predominantly white spaces, predominantly white institutions. And Kent State is no exemption from that. Kent State is a predominantly white institution. When you go into these spaces, already there are preconceived notions about who you are just because of the fact that you're a person of color. There's already, they already have their mind made up about who you are. And so when you go into these spaces, oftentimes the fearfulness that you feel is something called imposter syndrome. Imposter syndrome is when you feel like you don't belong. My colleagues told me that I didn't belong. They said that I wasn't talented enough to be there. They said that I didn't belong there. I didn't fit within the culture. That imposter syndrome, I let that chip away at me for the first 2 years while I was a professor. The first 2 years, I let that chip away at me. And then finally, my creator came to me and gave me a dose of fearlessness and gave me the courage to ask myself, why do I care what these people think about me? Why do I care about their perceptions? And so once I stop caring, once I stop worrying about their perceptions about me, then I was on fire. I was able to go around the world talking to thousands of people about my research and why I was the expert at that research. And so when you get that dose of fearlessness, you can do anything that you want. So the next thing I'm going to talk to you guys about is that integrity, okay? Integrity means doing the right thing and doing it all the time. When I was your age, I didn't have a full capacity of integrity. Integrity is something that you build over time. You build it through wisdom, through experience, through maturity. As you mature, your integrity also is supposed to get better, right? When I was your age, I used to go to the mall with my friends. We used to go and steal makeup and steal clothes, right? I did that. I'm sure some of you guys have probably done that too. I'm not the only one, right? So when you learn and you do better, your integrity level goes up. When you have a higher level of integrity, you have more peace in your life. Because all the energy that you're putting out into the universe is coming back to you in a positive way. I remember when I was in the fashion school a couple years ago, I invited an African artist to come and speak to the students and teach them about indigo dyeing. And so there was this one young lady that wanted to take my class. So she was about to be a senior. I think she had maybe like one more semester to graduate. And so she decided to take my class. For some reason, she didn't think that she was going to get added on another cost to her tuition for adding on my class. And so a couple weeks go by, the student gets a bill from the university just like everybody else gets their bill, and she's hooping and hollering, talking about how upset she is. She didn't realize she was going to have to pay. So my boss at the time comes to me and asked me to compromise my integrity. My boss asked me, well, if you just tell the registrar's office that she didn't come to class, then she can get her money back. She came to class. I was not about to lie for her, okay? I was not about to lie for her, and especially, and I'm a truthful, real person, okay? Kent State University, like I said, is a predominantly white institution. Most of my students were white. I was not about to lie for this little white girl. I was not about to do it. Not saying that I would lie for my black students, but I would never put my integrity on the line for someone white. No. I wouldn't do it. Black people have given too much already. I wouldn't do that. So be good to yourself. Do the right thing. Be kind. Only blessings will come back to you. There's something called karma. I'm sure you guys have heard of karma before, right? Karma's like that energy that we all have. Everybody here is made out of energy. Everybody here is energy. So the energy that you put out is the same energy that you're going to get. So if you put out blessings, if you put out positivity, you're going to get that back. So I'm going to talk to you guys now about being revolutionary, okay? Being revolutionary means that you're not afraid to be different. You're not afraid to walk outside the norm. You're not afraid to, as some people say, walk outside the circle. Or you're not afraid to think outside the box. Okay? In my opinion, there is no box. In my opinion, there is no glass ceiling. There's no limit to what it is I can do. I want to be able to impress upon you all that there's absolutely no limit to what you all can do. When you become revolutionary, when you think outside the box, oftentimes you're going to be pretty lonely because people aren't going to know how to handle it. When you're revolutionary and you think differently than the people around you, you're going to be lonely sometimes. People are going to fall off. And so I remember I have a friend of mine. She and I became friends when I was in the fifth grade. I loved her so much. We were like Ren and Stimpy. You guys remember Ren and Stimpy? You probably don't remember Ren and Stimpy. Okay, let me give you guys a reference that you can relate to. So she and I, we were like Chloe and Haley. We did everything together. She was my sister friend. I loved her to death. But when we both graduated, the difference between she and I was that we both had these amazing things that we wanted to do, but the difference was that she was not willing to put action behind what she wanted to do. And so because she didn't put action behind what she wanted to do, she ended up staying stagnant. She didn't go anywhere. And so I went off to college, and I remember when I came here a few weeks ago, a few of the students, I think it was Jatavius, had asked me about what was my experience like going to college. College was amazing. College saved my life because you know why? Because it gave me peace. When you're in the inner city, a lot of times you don't have peace. When you go off to college and you live in the dorms, you stay on campus, you get a chance to just have some peace. And so college was amazing to me. It saved my life. I loved going to college. And so as I got a chance to go to school and I started building up my mountain, my friend, she stayed on level ground. So I kept building. I kept getting more education. I kept getting different experiences in my life that helped me to grow. My mountain kept getting bigger, and she stayed on level ground. A little while after, the clouds started rolling in. I'm on top of my mountain, and I can't see her anymore. Excuse me, I am speaking. Thank you. Thank you. I appreciate your respect. Thank you. But like I was saying, my friend, she stayed on level ground while I kept growing. Those clouds started rolling in. I'm grabbing her hand because I'm trying to pull her along with me. She can't see me anymore because the clouds are in. I can't see her anymore. We still love each other. We still want to be best friends. But now because I'm up here, I'm on top of my mountain, and she's on level ground, not doing anything, we started to drift apart. I prayed that she would do something to put action behind what she wanted to do so that she could come up and she could build her own mountain and we could be back together. But she didn't do that. But she did ask me to come back down to level ground. And I couldn't do that. I couldn't do it. My mountain was way too high. My mountain was way too strong, and I was not about to go down to level ground where I knew I could do better. So you're going to have to walk by yourself sometimes.
Yes.
So the last part of fire is excellence.
Dr. Ellington, I thank you. Unfortunately, we have a time frame, and you have done an amazing job. An amazing job making sure that fire was exhibited in your speech. And so we really ask you at this time, give a hearty round of applause to our guest speaker, Ms. Dr. Ellington.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Now for the moment that we know you all have been waiting for. I am going to ask Dr. Trent Mosley if he would join me at the stage so we can certify this class of 2021.
Network leaders, class advisors, and faculty, do you attest to the fact that these students here have satisfactorily completed the requisite course of study prescribed by the Board of Education of the Cleveland Metropolitan School District and the Ohio Department of Education?
Again, remember, it's a dignified event. We just want to get through it, and we want every young person recognized accordingly. We certify that all the students on this stage this evening have met the educational requirements of the state and Ohio, the state of Ohio and the Cleveland Metropolitan School District, and attest that these students are now ready to receive their diplomas.
Now, by the authority of the Board of Education of the Cleveland Metropolitan School District, I have the high honor to bestow upon you, the graduates of Glennville High School class of 2021, their diploma tonight, along with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto. Congratulations.
This will be the last time you hear my name, and we are honoring our young people. Before we begin, again, we are asking that you please hold your applause. We want everyone to embrace this moment, and we want to give honor to these young people. Give it up for 2021. Please remain seated. We have a photographer that's going to make sure every last one of your young people, or at least stay away from the stage as we honor these young people. Thank you.
Feels so good to make it this far, and I didn't think I could take it so long. There were days I wanted to quit. I said, surely this is it. But I held on.
Keyshawn Crowell.
Watched our so-called friends turn and walk away.
Ian Ivory.
And it hurt so much, I didn't have words to say. But even when my day turns to night and nothing seems as right.
Keyshawn Alford.
Lord, I thank you for my life.
Eric Dungy.
Lord, I thank you for every victory in you I've seen and all the moments I know, Lord, it was you who kept me. So I thank you for my life. And I've watched you take my family from there to here. And when times were a little rough, God, I know you were near. Thank you, Jesus.
The Chances Hightower.
I was reminded of your gifts, so
I got it. Tayshawn Baring. Makaya Shahid. Regine A. Barfio. Denaya Kathy Marie Foster. Kanaya W. Howard.
And for the moment, God, I know you can be.
Sharian and it. Ashante Black. Amari Carson. Simone Williams. Anthony Lewis. D. Wandale D. Gray.
Thank you, Jesus, for my life. It may not be all that I'd hope for, and every dream has not yet been realized. But to see your face one day, God, I know it's all gonna be worth it. Yeah, yeah, Lord. So I thank you for every mountain, every valley, God, everything.
Jarius Johnson.
I know it was you, God.
Tyon Farmer. Kasani Haran. Mercedes Scott. Chanel Austin.
Naya Dunlap. Ayana Parrish. Taisha Townsend. Jashurion Robinson Welch. Isis Moore. And it hurt so much I didn't have words to say. But even when my day turns to Jasmine Malik. Tori Thompson. And all the moments I know, Lord, it was you. Devin Smith. So I thank you for my life. And I've watched you take my family from there to here. And when times were a little rough, God, I know you were near. Thank you, Jesus. And the moments I thought, Derek Harvey. I was reminded of your nails, so I held on. Tayshawn Conley. There's nothing I. Deborah Jackson. Shantavia Smith. I thank you for my life. For my life. Lord, I thank you. Malaysia Backus. My Vice President, Denasia Smith. Some didn't make it. I could have been one of the ones who lost my way. Justice Phillips. Anaya Hendrick. Dantasia Hill. Jediah Woods. And every dream has not yet been realized. But to see your face. Ashanti Cole. Cortez Willett. Thank you for Jonathan Evans. I just want to take the time.
say thank you, Jesus, for my life. Oh, thank you, Jesus, for my life.
Quantice Wilhoy. Jatavius Buford. Ayana Cooley. Janae S. Gibson. Joanna R. Strozier. Makisha Atkinson.
Thank you for
Tamara Sankey.
Ashanti Axel.
Watch to take my family from there to here. And when times were a little rough, God, I know you.
Shania Wright.
Jesse J.
In the moments I thought I failed, I was reminded of your name. So
Jesse James. Javon Spencer. Amari Simone, Honori Simone Caldwell, number 10. Janae L. Thomas, number 9. Aaliyah Crowell.
Deja Miller. McKenna Ackerson.
Thank you for every mountain, every valley, God, everything that you brought me through. Thank you for. I know it was you, God.
Terrell Cooper. Latana Reeve and my treasurer.
All right now.
Ready? Denisha Forsen, Sululuta Toria. Number one and class president, valedictorian, Tanaya Parker.
I want to dedicate this song to all of the parents and the families, and you know, it's been a really rough year, everybody, but we thank God for pulling us through.
Gone through, Lord, it was you. Hey, through all that I have gone through, Lord, it was you. It was you. It was you pulling me through. It was you, it was you, pulling me through all that we have gone through, God, it was you, yes, it was, through all that we have gone through. God, it was you. Hey, it was you. It was you. pulling me through. It was you, Lord, it was you, pulling me through. Hey, when I stumbled, when I cried, when I felt like I wanted to die, when my friends turned and they walked away, you were right there to stay. It was you, it was you, pulling me through. It was you, it was you. He'll never walk out on you. No, never, no, never. Hey, he'll never walk out on you. No, never, no, never. Hey, he'll never walk out on you. No, never, no, never. I'm so glad the Lord is not like people. He'll never walk out on you. No, never. No, never. Hey, he'll never walk out on you. No, never. No, never. No, never. Hey, I'm a witness that he'll never, no, never, no, never. I'm a witness that he'll never, no, never, no, never. You pulling us through, and we thank you, God. It was you, Lord, it was you pulling us through.
Good evening, everyone. I am Class Treasurer, Class of 2021. Now turn your tassel.